Hello and welcome to Let's Playtest World's End.
For the first time in a long time.
Yeah.
Although to be fair, actually we did attempt one earlier, but the microphone was dead.
Yeah. That end, I believe that's where I found out that OBS here does not work well with the playtest window. So we're not using that.
So we're just going to be rocking with Bandicam for this.
Yeah. Alright, so let's get the mouse out of the window for this. So, let's see what I've done with Apocalypse Saga, shall we?
Oh. Dill has a nose bandage.
Oh!
Well, looks well, judging from the crack... Yeah, you could tell... What told you that? The pages, the crack, or the blood mark on the wall?
And right off the bat, we have a mission, and Stella's immediately misunderstanding the situation.
Potions don't keep your fatal states.
Well, to be fair to him, he's currently functioning off of Kingdom Hearts logic, not Final Fantasy logic. Because I recall in Kingdom Hearts, at least, there was no Phoenix Down.
Kingdom Hearts do revive people.
Yeah.
As well as your...
Yeah. So, here he finds out that that does not work here. Yeah. Here's a hint, Stell. Phoenix Downs are not spell components.
And by the way, maybe if you're going to go for a store, maybe you should take a wallet, your parents' wallet. I'm sure they'd understand an emergency. Of course, in a panic, you can't be expected to think of these things.
Yeah.
Yes, your parents might be in a life-threatening emergency, but you still have to pay.
And he's advising us to try money grinding now. And we don't even have to walk far.
This is gonna end well.
Oh, you have no idea. Ouch! Okay, random number gods don't like me today.
And this is Reacher, I'm guessing.
Yep. This is Gerald Reacher. Interesting point, but I really don't see why you can't make an exception. And with that, we just yoink a phoenix down from the shelves. Because goddammit, we need that phoenix down. Except this is not how phoenix downs are supposed to behave.
So guessing something odd's afoot here.
And end flashback. So, after that personal mission was basically a failure. And that's going to be haunting us for the rest of the game. Beyond that, a whole lot has changed since World's End was Apocalypse Saga. For starters, there's now a classing system, including... Yeah. Well, Stell can't take those for lore reasons. He's mainly just decided to abandon those on account of he has what he needs from them. Particularly this thing.
Yeah, I've pretty much seen most of this during our botched attempt at this. So.
Yep. And also, for those of you who haven't seen, Stell now has a justification for having mana tap. Yeah. Also, so, as a battle mage, Stell has access to lots of weapon enchantment, which syncs stupidly well with elemental magic. Like, doubles its power. Black Mage is, well, Final Fantasy standard, and holy crap, I gave him a lot to start with. Oh yeah, that's right. This game runs on an active time battle system now. It's essentially locked on weight, but you take evasion and critical avoidance penalties when you're in casting time. So, Black Mage has an ability to nullify that. Red Mage. Not Final Fantasy standard. I've basically taken double cast and run with it until I had less a jack of all trades and more an out and out speed blitzer. So, pre-charge to start battle with full AT at the cost of doubled MP costs. Dual cast to cast two spells in a row, and blitz so that I can take an action immediately after that resolves. A lot of action economy here, and I may have broken the game just with that one class. And as for Planesweaver, well, this is what happened to his old move pool. And there is a whole lot more explanation to do there, but I will take care of it as we go. So, for Max, he is the Chihiro replacement on account of I don't want to get involved in as much... On account of I'm trying to use more original characters here. So, he has access to the big core spells in the Alchemist set, including a nuke. Oh right, I had him start with this. Oh god, he gets plus 50% item lore right off the bat for all of his classes. Oh Jesus, this is gonna be fun. So, machinist, hardcore.
You might notice something eerily familiar about this. If you actually pay attention to what these moves do. Particularly those who played Final Fantasy VI.
Yep. Granted, I've had to take some liberties where engine limitations come into play, but...
Well, the Pilotator did not do that in Final Fantasy VI.
Yeah, and the Energy Blades equivalent in Final Fantasy VI did not do increased crit damage. In fact, I don't think it could crit.
Energy Blade was the chainsaw, wasn't it?
Yep.
And in Final Fantasy VI, it would have had a chance to do instant death.
Yep. Beyond...
It's funny how you managed to get Soul Anchor to work, though.
Yeah.
I guess it'd be possible to get Energy Blades to the Debilitator to work like they would be, but it would have taken a long time.
Yeah, Debilitator would be needlessly complicated, and Energy Blades would be an out-and-out game breaker.
At this point, anyway.
Beyond the Final Fantasy VI reference, we have an otherwise anti-Magitek class. Unfortunately, if you run into a Magitek hybrid with something else, you're kind of screwed. He also has and can use White Mage and Geomancer. White Mage is Final Fantasy standard. Although he doesn't have Absorb MP yet.
Also, do you mind explaining the weird blue stars next to some of these?
Oh, that's to indicate the mana cost.
Speaking of mana cost, Geomancer is kind of interesting in that none of its abilities have mana costs. The justification being that it's working off of the environmental mana. Another fun fact, it's not restricted by terrain. Modified by terrain, yes. Restricted, no. For example, Gelatinize here, its element explicitly depends on its terrain, on the terrain. Earth Render does more damage in mountains, Air Render does more damage in forests. You can figure out the rest on your own. Okay, so... You might also notice the weapon emblems here. I don't think that was here when Phoenix last commented.
Yeah, I kind of wanted to point something out, but...
Basically, that's the weapon of choice bonus. So, Stell, for example, has a weapon of choice of swords.
It's dangerous to go alone.
Yeah, I had some fun with the flavor text this time around. So yeah, basically whenever Stell has a sword equipped, he gets +8 to his critical hit rate.
Ooh.
And whenever Max has Magitek equipped, I think I gave him a +4 to evade rate? So yeah, it gets very fun very quickly.
And here's Ty.
Eternally...
boisterous.
Exuberant as always has been. Hey.
Yeah.
The werewolves of London. I don't know if... I get the weird feeling they should not know about that song on the web.
I was just winging it for the most part. Whew.
They finally learned how to add 2+2.
Actually, it's worse than that. They have alchemists.
I know that. I was making a joke.
Okay. And oh yeah, there are cockatrices in the woods now. Huh. Oh, yes. Speaking of Strider...
In other words, an invite to get your butt whooped.
Oh, that's not... That's the... That barely scratches the surface. And with Ty in the party... Actually, first off, you may notice she doesn't have the emblem. That's because her weapon of choice...
Is she doesn't...
Is not what she has equipped.
Anyway, so she's still very much the Blue Mage, which means she learns most of her stuff by taking hits from the spell she wants to learn, and once she learns the learning passive, can do so regardless of her main class. Also, Power Siphon takes a few notes from Kibari from Final Fantasy X. Beyond that, we have the Arcanite, which is a hardcore combat-oriented class. Oh yes, it has Sturdy. And a pre-charge clone. Paladin is slow but powerful. And she has cover. So she is your party's tank. And she has the very much not tanky Berserker. Which, well...
Primal War. I guess he'd probably be a master at that.
Oh god, yeah. Well...
Knowing her.
And on top of that, they get a monk passive. And something new that I've added. Critical Haste. So yeah, you're probably gonna be maining her as a blue mage for a good long while.
So this goes a little more high-tech enough to use computers, I see.
Yep.
Compared to the medieval-style crap of the old days.
Yeah. Long story short, the expanded tile set that MV has is allowing me to do a lot more. And here we're introduced to Zoe Solaire.
Funny how he has black hair and yet she's a redhead. I completely forgotten that from last time. You think she's cute as a button? Well, you ain't seen nothing yet, because just as a warning, I may have expanded one of the upcoming characters' backstories by connecting them with a new character of sorts.
That's right, we've expanded the character roster. Just not the playable roster.
Who have we added? Well, you'll have to see for yourself. Because I ain't telling. I'm just gonna let the guess. That's what drive you crazy.
Oh yeah, and Zoe is sensitive about the topic of her age. And just as just for the sake of integrating gameplay and story, there actually was an Echo Herb in the inventory prior to this. Just one, unfortunately.
An intro course of an 80% flunk rate.
Very strict teacher right here. So, Dante once again uses swords.
Okay, so I feel the need to explain these classes. So Invoker has taken dual influences. For starters, a stance system inspired by Etrian Odyssey, which selectively shows the abilities here, and a Final Fantasy Tactics reference in that weapons have abilities bound to them, and the Invoker class is the only class that can use those abilities. Unfortunately, doing so also drains that weapon's mana, which functions as its durability. Because a lot of the weapons...
So it sounds like... For me, that crazily sounds like Etrian, the Final Fantasy Tactics meets the Diablo games.
Oh, God. okay.
Suddenly I have bad flashbacks of trying to play the first game and getting wrecked.
Battle Mage. Same as ever?
That's because I wasn't leveling up properly, because in that game you actually choose what... Every time you level up, you get to choose which points go into what attributes.
Yeah.
And I didn't know which attributes I wanted the best to put in, or like...
So Battle Mage is more of same, and Dante is actually more of a physical-based character, so... He's not able to take as much advantage of it, but... It's an option. Spell Fencer, well... Hardcore Mage Killer. Especially with that low HP bonus.
And since the blue star's mana, I'm guessing that heart next to meltdown is health.
Yep.
Oh boy, that's one spell that from the Final Fantasy games that I don't think anyone's ever used. Or has someone used it, and I've just never heard of it.
People have used it before. But in this game, meltdown is not an overpowered fire elemental attack. In fact, in this game, it's actually a splash targeting holy elemental attack. Weirdly enough. Oh god. I gave this class reflex. Oh, this is gonna be fun. And the Black Knight is basically a black mage with some competency in melee attacking.
Where's Leon from FF2? Yes, I went there.
Okay. And
I've been watching a walkthrough of that game. I should get back to that.
Yeah. Anyway, so Zoe has more taken a page from the Pathfinder tabletop role-playing game. As a telepath, well, she gets access to some very powerful stuff.
So is like causing someone to have a seizure?
Yep.
Ugh. Epileptics run the other way. Heck, even if you're not epileptic, run the other way.
heck! Anybody run the other way, because cardiac crisis!
Oh, right.
Oh yeah, she also gets an ability that prevents random encounters from resulting in you being blindsided.
Surgery? I don't think I've ever heard of that word before.
That was basically a name ripped and modified from the Pathfinder. Scions thing. Taunting Visage, I don't think is one you've seen.
I feel like that would be better for a different type of character.
Well, wait for it, because we'll get to some characters that telepath ability really syncs well with, or some classes, I mean. Kineticist is, well, typical hurling things. But it also works on a much, 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 much smaller scale than that.
Absolute Zero is medium-high damage. I find that hard to wrap around. That sounds like it would be the name of the most powerful fire spell.
Ice.
Ice, yeah, bleh. I forget my elements.
And Nomad, oh my god, I actually implemented this. It's another pre-charge clone! Oh god.
Well, creating a singularity.
Alright. Nomad also gets an instant death spell thing. And Seer.
Fate screw.
So dissonant that it's sickening!
It's like, what? Part of me feels that if there was a Five Nights at Fuckboys version of this, it would be Fate Well, you know.
Yeah. Oh my goodness, lifelink. Pretty good for when you want her to survive for a while. yeah, she also gets an instant cast Libra. And a sturdy clone. And Destiny Bond! As an incubus, well, she specializes more in messing with the body than the mind. Oh yeah, another thing. Damage over time is elemental in this. Or can be elemental, at least. Oh my god, so many tanking options!
Cool shield. Wouldn't it be just simpler to call mana shield? I mean, that's...
It would, if Zoe didn't have a completely different resource.
Oh. I guess I didn't notice that.
And Shaper, well... Shaper's kind of the game-breaker to compensate for the fact that it is the slowest of our classes. I do believe this is the only line-targeting paralysis inflictor in the game. AE re-raise, temporary HP, and a much more durable damage prevention shield. So yeah, you can see Zoe is kind of a tank.
All right, so now then. Ah, yes. The warp wire. An item name taken straight from Etrian Odyssey. Oh, yeah. Is it me, or is it actually hilarious that the ether is the cheapest thing in the shop outside of the warp wire?
Hmm. Oh, wow, that's just pretty cheap, surprisingly.
Yeah.
I was always found it weird how in most RPGs it's always the most one of the more expensive things.
Alright, so...
Find it weird how this school has a frickin' floating island in the sky. Has an arena and a floating, gliding island in the sky. Yeah, I'm with you there.
As Stella's about to say... I love how you're questioning that and not how they built a plane of existence to house Threat Center's sparring ring. And here we meet Sarah Strider. Who... I'm not even going to beat around the bush here. She is going to wreck you so hard.
Enter the realm of get good dunked on surprise butt sex.
Always better than that. Oh, I actually get to take a turn now. Oh, nope, no, I don't. God damn it. God damn it, she faked me out. Says the woman who beat five people on her own. Without even trying.
Careful what you say.
Alright. Oh yeah, this is the one explaining blue magic.
talk about your lessons in pain. And this is basically the one explaining a brief snippet on geoeffects. Nothing particularly interesting. Okay. Something tells me that, like the usual, I'm going to be searching for this a lot. Okay, nothing. Nothing. Nothing.
He's doing this and yet it's his own game.
I'm debating on whether to put...
ones in the other one?
Yeah, I'm debating on whether to put ones in to put... data into those others. Okay. Ah! Oh, right. Fun fact! Dying in this game has a chance of giving you any of these six injuries.
Ooh.
So, for the broken arm, your strength is cut in half, the ability double hand is disabled, and your critical hit rate is reduced. For the fractured leg, your evasion is reduced, and the default guard command does not mitigate damage. A fractured rib makes you more likely to be hit with a critical hit. Coughing up blood. I was struggling to come up with a relevant effect for this, but basically it increases mana costs and decreases AP gain in this. A concussion decreases your accuracy, evasion, critical hit rate, and critical avoidance. So, lots of bleh. Internal bleeding is probably the worst because it reduces your max health. Okay. Oh god, I actually implemented this. Having subpar item lore results in certain items having bad effects. For example, the antidote, when used by someone with item lore less than 100%, does the opposite of what it's supposed to. The paralysis cure can bring paralysis back onto you. And the confusion remedy can lower your agility. Okay. So, I believe now we're going to run into a possible explanation for why the Phoenix Down did not work in the opening cutscene. The human soul only stays in the material plane for up to 24 hours. And the Phoenix Down cannot do its job on a body without a soul. Alright, anyway. Alright. There's also going to be certain creatures that are visible on the map. Sure to Etrian Odyssey, which inspired most of them, they are going to be very, very, very dangerous. For starters, we have one pretty much ripped from Etrian Odyssey, the Fury Horn, whose scream leaves you in such a panic that you are confused, or excuse me, as his skin calls it, maddened, and likely to attack your allies. Fortunately for you, silence shuts them down.
And of course we have the thing that has plagued many an RPG player since time immemorial.
Oh god, mimics! Oh man. Yeah. Oh yeah, I've given them a buff. They can imitate doors now.
Ooh. That's scary.
Not just treasure chests. Even worse, that's just the juveniles. The adults can imitate people.
Disaster.
One of the main reasons why ethers are so cheap in this setting. And yet, in World's End, nobody knows how the hell it happened. Whew.
All right.
So, we need to move up, gone with the plot.
Yep. I wonder how much of that I'm going to fast forward over. Okay, so, wait a minute. Reclass. Let's get you back as Blue Mage so that you can actually learn some of the stuff that this next boss has to offer.
Oh, yes. Our favorite character that we, in spite of all the different versions, we have refused to throw out.
None shall pass. Whoa, where? Whoa, who are you? Where did you come from? Really? What? No one gets that? Monty Python? Holy Grail? Just tell me who you are and where you came from. No appreciation for humor, I swear. Name's Exotria. Pleased to make your acquaintance, you humorless fuck. God, I love that line! Oh! Oh my goodness!
Surprise!
Proceed. Wait, were you recording that whole thing?
I'm going to have some stuff to cut out, yes.
So this is what Snoopy's dog, the inside of Snoopy's doghouse looks like.
Oh, Jesus, the concept of reality marbles. Thank you, Nasuverse, for this!
What?
I get the feeling that would be a lot of explanation.
Watch as I make all your problems go away. It's just the god he turned into...
Bad breath. Oh, hey, no one got paralyzed! That is a first! Make up your mind, random number gods! Oh, silence on Stell. Okay, that shuts him down quite nicely. Let's go mana tap. Oh god, what are you going to do here? Okay, so let's go Geo Shield on Ty. Cover. Wait a minute, before I do anything. She's not poisoned, is she? Good. Behold! The power of Zoe Solaire, the Immortal. Okay. So, I am going to mana tap here. Because I seriously need... Okay, there we go! Expert card. And because it's a limit, well, and because it's a limit, I can do this.
Nothing.
Well, I'm covering with Expert Guard active. I And what does Hector Picard do? Oh yes, nullifies all direct damage.
Ooh.
Yeah.
And oh lord, it's that tat thing with the divine shield crap from the old Apocalypse Saga again. That glitch.
Oh god.
Certain moves.
It wasn't so much a glitch as an exploit. Okay, and pass turn. Overhead stance. And then start wailing away at his magic points. Switch to the back line. Gamma. Hey, I learned Drain Touch.
And you poisoned yourself, buddy. Bravo.
That is a nasty strength buff there. So I'm going to pass turn to keep Expert Guard up. Bye-bye, Mana Pool! Oh, Jesus. I'm realizing how overpowered this group is. And I haven't even given Zoe her temporary health yet.
Oh, I see what you're doing. You're forcing him to waste time restoring his mana.
Bye-bye, Mana Pool. Behold! Oh wait, no. She's not there yet. Behold! Zoe is now nigh unkillable. That's Drain Touch.
Get good, Exotia. She pass. That's a nice everything you have there.
Woo! God, I had fun with that one.
Hello there.
Hi. Who are you?
Just a guy who broke you out of Exotia's reality marble.
Well, thanks, I guess. I don't even know where to begin voicing this one.
Yeah, I get that a lot.
If you'll excuse us, sir, we have a Protector's Guild to get to, so if you don't mind, we're leaving now.
Protector's Guild? You work for the World Protection Agency?
Basically, yes. What of it?
Name's Victor. I posted a mission to the nearest establishment. It should be marked high priority. Here's my communicator ID in case you need to get in touch. Yeah, I'm sorry, the Skype buttons at the bottom are blocking part of that. If there was a way to make those go away,
The man hands over a small slip of paper. Good to know!
Actually, since you're going through that forest, can you do me a favor?
That depends. Name it.
I have an adoptive daughter who wandered off a while back. I think she's still in there somewhere.
You let your kid go in there?
Something like that. She normally sticks to me like glue. But she really likes exploring, so she must have wandered pretty deep in. I've been searching for over half an hour for her, and I've got nothing to show for it. If you see her, at least make sure she gets to town all right.
Missing daughter? I'm normally not a fan of escort missions, but I guess I can add that to the list of unofficial missions. We do kind of owe you for saving our necks, after all.
Thanks. I'll be waiting in the next town.
How will we know it's her?
Trust me, you'll know. So yeah, Phoenix is now technically a daddy.
Okay, so...
Who, once again, I am not telling.
Alright, so... I've expanded on the geek crystals.
It's going to blow your little mind.
Okay, so, I've expanded on the gate crystals. There's four types. One, the gray crystal, does nothing. The green crystal here stores a teleport anchor. So now I can actually use the warp wires we got.
Huh.
The blue gate crystal will restore you to full HP and MP. And there's a gold gate crystal that will repel enemy encounters. Though I've had that one's range buffed from 3 to 5 tiles between or in the transition from Apocalypse Saga to World's End.
Nice.
So, do we keep going, or...?
You know what, let's keep going.
Okay. Ah!
Because there's another addition to this scene from the last time I've seen... Granted, I don't know how deep it's in, but there's another cutscene somewhere in this forest.
Yeah.
That was recently added for the...
For the most recent update, yeah. Exploiting elemental weaknesses! For the win! Actually, what the heck?
Gain 2 blue magics in one fight. Crazy. Again, I have no idea how deep this cutscene in the forest the cutscene is. Is it somewhere?
It should be in the next map.
Ah.
Though, knowing me, it might be a lot deeper than that, so don't hold me to anything. Oh yeah, one fun thing about the mana blobs. They succumb to the Final Fantasy VI sickness of dying when their mana pool is depleted.
So hitting them with a...
So hitting them with Dusk Strike...
Dusk Strike
long enough
them.
Would kill them. Good thing they have mana regen to account for that. Unfortunately, a few good crits can still do them in. Crit. Blitz. He's down. Line. Face move. Oh yeah. And Fate Link.
Surprise.
So anyway, Fate Link here is an interesting little ability. You hit it, you use it on the party, or on the opposing party, and all single target attacks damage everything else.
Huh.
I'm going to be saving this one for a much larger enemy formation. But beyond that, it's time to do some trolling. Oh yeah, and a quick demonstration. Elemental absorption is a thing now.
Ooh. Again, this was any other game. I think these early slimes would have been easier to kill. Well, and the slimes that run on these rules would be don't come up later.
Okay, so how many ethers? Okay. So in other words, I need to slow down a little on the mana consumption. Ah! Oh, it's the cockatrices. Oh, lordy loo, it's the cockatrices. Oh god!
The heck?
Long story short.
Oh.
Yeah, their basic attacks inflict that. What am I doing? Why am I attacking with Ty and guarding with Dante? What am I doing? And that didn't help me anyway. That is a critical health cockatrice. Very scary. Oh? Oh god! Alright, doing it right this time.
Thank you.
Okay, I was worried about the critical health one because when they're low on health, the cockatrices will start spamming Stony Glare, which is instant petrification. Ugh.
And all we got are white feathers for that, whatever they do.
They're vendor trash. Oh, hey, an Echo Orb. What are we... Oh, this is the encounter where...
No, not the bees.
This is the encounter where Fate Link would have been the most useful, and I blew it on the cockatrices!
Music seems to be drowning you out there.
I blew Fate Link on the cockatrices!
You're still being drowned out.
Be right back. Okay, we're back. Now I feel like a complete dumbass. Okay, line shift.
Maybe it would have been best if you turned the music off.
Maybe.
Because music seems to be what kills us the most with these things lately.
Mm-hmm. How to tell when there's too many enemies on the field.
Is that actually useful?
It's more vendor trash.
Insect wing. Why would you loot this? That's just what I was thinking. In fact, you know what? Maybe you should turn off the music just so it doesn't. There's less things drowning you out on my end.
That's fair. Eh.
Yeah, sorry guys, but when it comes to battling, it's way too loud.
Yeah. Okay.
Until the guy, at least until the guys who are on Skype get off their asses.
Okay, so fun fact about the goblins: they have healers. And goblin punch hurts. Ow. And bye-bye, Maniple. There we go, there's Goblin Punch.
And the mage is reduced to punching.
Oh, right. I allowed you to change equipment mid-battle. Unfortunately, unless you've started a new battle, there's a 3-turn cooldown between equipment changes. Okay.
Punch.
Oh, wow. Woo! That was a lot of damage. Alright, line shift. Let's finish him off.
Yeah, shut up, cat.
Yay!
Wait a minute, the chemist's corpse go?
Oh, right. That is a glitch that I have yet to fix. That is a glitch that I have yet to figure out what's going on. For some reason, whenever you enter the equip change menu, any dead enemies on the field will vanish once you leave the equip scene.
Well, that's curious.
Yeah. Whether they're supposed to or not. Okay.
This is a very different experience without background music.
Yeah. Music that's different. Try being in the shoes of guys who play games that have copyrighted music and have to mute their music.
Oh, Jesus, yeah. Oh! Oh, God! Oh, bass row.
Huh.
Increase item lore. Since we have an alchemist who already has boosted alchemy! Oh, God! This is gonna break stuff! Breaks stuff so hard. Okay, so the temporary hit points and the rune buff have not gone away.
Is that intentional or is that...
That is intentional.
Ah. Does it ever go away?
It does. If rune stops a sufficient amount of damage, it will go away.
Huh. Although I think the main reason is because no one's really been attacking Zoe.
Yeah. Goodbye to your int. And your mana pool. Or pieces of it. Ah! And there it goes. Okay, so. I'm gonna have to get it back. Excuse me while I fast forward through this. You know what? I'm a blow mana font. Chemist spam for the win!
Yeah, we're sick of you.
I just wanted Roomba back.
You mean nothing to us now.
Okay. Let's boom. No, let's not. Let's. Let's boom. And gust. Take advantage of unbalance. And wind element. Okay, so. Nuke? Oh, not nuke. Nuke! Bye bye, mana pool. And now Stella's out of MP. Oh my goodness, wait a minute. This is not a recommended situation. This is so not a recommended situation. Yay, regen buff! And crit. Get my mana back to full.
All you gotta do is press B to blow.
Is it sad or awesome that I know exactly what you're referencing here? Okay, come on, little thing. Thank you! Okay, if I'd left that alone, it would've launched a fissure at itself and healed. Yay!
Ether, is that worth it?
Eh. Maybe? It'll save you a few gil at the town, that's for damn sure. Oh my god, line target abilities become party target when you're all on the same line. That is awesome. Okay, so. How am I gonna go about this? Overhead stance. Let's water blob. Alright, spell strike, min blob, dust strike. Bam. Bye bye, mana pool. No, that's a healing spell. Alright then. Mind break. Boom. Try it. Oh, no crit. God damn it, I can't play my own game. Alright, let's get everyone's rows back in order.
Please don't be sly.
I may have made the random encounter rate too high here. Oh well, at least they're easy to run from. Can't exactly say the same for the cockatrices.
Alright, you hungry, Chris? Dinner's ready.
Oh, that's something else to cut out.
You hungry, Kate?
So much lag. Probably from the screen share. Okay. Area nuke. And let's have shockwave area on standby. Okay. Alright, the bees have a poison proc with their basic attacks. As per AS. Oh, of course I miss. Too many enemies on screen! I render. Good lord, that was some split damage. What am I doing?
And hold on a minute.
Alright, so, moving. Yeah.
Sorry about that.
I was just taking this time to see P-Grind.
Seriously, with your limited MP restorative, you decided to go grinding. How much are we gonna have to chipmunk voice out of this?
Probably at least most of the time you were gone.
Well, at the very least, yeah, basically be turned into the two new kings of the squirrels.
Oh, God.
Oh, have we got every treasure here, or is...
On this map, we should have every treasure now.
Thank you, something easy to kill.
Well, moderately easier. Well, easier.
Goblin punch.
Oh, crap, not him!
That could have been worse.
Oh, yeah, it could be much worse. Okay, there goes Rune. Okay, let's send you into the back line, so you don't get gob-punched again. Okay, so you could be a big problem. Okay, so, overhead stance.
One shot.
Chemist down. Mage down. Everybody at full health. Oh crap, I forgot to cover. Ow.
So he's alive. That's what was really important here.
And now they're dead. Alright, so let's get you subclasses. Oh, the creative ways people come up with to save on items.
Here's a Grey Gate crystal. I am taking to JT's saving method.
Huh? Never say those words. It's always something. There be something in the bush.
Okay, maybe it was deeper than I thought it was. It's official. We're going to have to squirrel voice a lot of this. Oh, hey! We run into the Fury Horde.
Oh, boy.
So, basically, the only way to stand a chance against this thing is to surprise butt-sex it.
Butt-sex, butt-sex, butt-sex.
Okay. Okay, so... First things first, let's start spamming the hell out of Gust.
What is that? What it's weak to?
No, I'm taking advantage of unbalance.
Alright, so...
That went really well.
Oh, God! Okay, so...
may as well be a surprise butt sex.
Yeah! Oh, God. Oh, hey, there's another one! You know what? I'm going to... briefly turn BGM back on, so we can hear...
I'm not going to stab you. I'm not going to stab you.
All right. So, I am not going to bank on the crit this time, especially since Dante is now low on MP.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, another thing to worry about, it also doesn't have a mana pool.
With it being paralyzed, I'm correct in assuming it's harmless?
Essentially.
Troll dead end.
And more random encounters. Oh, this is where the spiders were.
Looks like Dr. Smith's Legion of Spiders has come to visit us.
Dr. Smith?
You obviously haven't seen Lost in Space, have you?
No.
It's mainly at the end. It's kind of goofy.
Okay.
So, if you can't just find the movie, watch the Nostalgia Critics review.
Okay.
That'll basically clue you in.
Alright, I should really stop spamming overhead stance.
What the?
Jeez, did I not give them any critical avoidance? Ooh. Ugh. That is a nasty status condition. Slow. All right. Just for that. Ow! Stop it! For that. Die. Oh, come on, I said die. Die. And duck.
A wolf among the lambs.
And as an added bonus, we now have sticky web as blue magic.
You can magically create webs. Magically create spider webs. A little silly, but okay.
Alright, so add the bar.
Congratulations, Ty. You have officially become Spider-Man. Or Spider Woman. Technically. Bleh. Although technically that was a thing.
Yeah, kinda was.
And oh, well this what area was short.
Actually, this is a side path.
Side path?
Lots of echo herbs and more bees. Oh, and she's just shy of being able to use her limits. epic lag, because there's too much shit on the field.
We're not going to blow you away. We're not going to blow you away.
Oh? Ah!
That sucks.
Indeed it does! God damn it, game! Yay, Airwinder goes off! Whack, 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 whack. Oh! They lived!
You've got to be kidding.
Oh! Why? How? What? Well, at least Ty's taking the brunt of the damage here. The only party member who could feasibly take it. Well, I guess I'm blowing Fate Link. Because I really want a basic attack. It turns out that one basic attack was all I needed. Oh my god.
Is that really all that's down here?
There's also a shop this way. Or wandering merchant
thing.
Do you
really want to be going down here at this point?
Eh, fair enough. Okay. Ah, the goblins have B rank agility, where most of the party has C rank. This is not gonna be easy to run from! Okay. Move. Oh god!
Well, that could have ended badly.
That could have ended so much worse. Okay. So, the real annoying part here is that the Goblin Mage has access to status spells, which are line target, and therefore not stopped by cover. Boom. Come on. Really? Oh, speaking of... none left. Okay, so let's head down here another time. And let's control walk our way out of here.
Cockatrices, of course. Well, I know what I don't want Stell be in. Front row. Okay, good. None of them brucked. So, Gamma, break kills. Oh, piss.
Ah, piss.
What am I doing? God damn, Ty, that is a strong crit. Okay, so, boost it. Yeah. Alright. I'm not sure I want to be doing that just yet. I don't want to risk a stony glare. Single target air render. And let's use Vanguard. Okay, so overhead stance. Crushing strike. Yes! Glorious overkill! Okay. So, now that we've got Ty in Vanguard, we can reasonably afford to... Ooh, okay. This is going to be fun. Oh, okay. There we go. Saved by Air Render. Took him long enough. Oh, hey, it dropped a black feather. Still vendor trash, but a lot, but... Oh. Oh, this is something the spider dropped, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. So, and it could be used to inflict poison.
Huh.
So, what? I'm not going to stab you. I'm not.
Okay, so. So, as a just in case.
I'm not going to stab you. I'm not going to stab you.
First strike.
I stabbed you.
Alright, gust. Okay. Oh, I just realized Zoe's gone on for a while without rune buff. Actually, if memory serves, this is the Furyhorn that killed us during the run through without the mic on.
Well, revenge it is sweet then.
Yes, revenge it is very sweet. Okay.
Yeah, did you forget about me, bozo?
Alright, so. Let's savey save. There it is again. Should we? Or should it wait for the... Okay.
What?
Okay. Whoa! Where's the sprite?
Okay, hold up, my guys. This is...
Sorry about that, had a bit of a... Whoa, okay.
You forget to unpause?
No, I didn't forget to unpause.
Just okay. Curious.
Alright, so important note to self. MV has mouse capabilities! By default! Alright, so...
Yeah, kill it, got...
It looks harmless enough. That's also what you said about the mana blobs and cockatrices.
Wow, she thought those were all... So, yeah, we've officially acquired something. Granted, if you were looking carefully at this part, you might have been able to guess. Some clever people might be able to guess what it is, but...
We're not revealing anything just yet. And... Oh my goodness! Yes! Healing!
You have a healing spray? And, wow, that's a lot of blobs.
Indeed it is. And I'm also putting background music on because this is also... A theme that the game hasn't played before.
So we're basically going to be doing this for that.
Yeah.
I guess pseudo-boss, kind of.
Yeah.
Oh god, is the Nickelodeon logo come to life and attack us?
Actually!
Holy Blob and Dark Blob.
Yeah, two elements we don't have access to yet.
So we have to...
So...
what we have.
Yeah. So, essentially, the shtick of the two is... Dark element gets stronger... I think the higher the caster's MP and... Or, no. Higher the caster's... Or lower the caster's HP and higher the target's MP. And wholly punishes you for saving up limits. Okay. The important thing, though, is that the holy blobs are healers.
Actually hear this music. Well, at least I'll be able to hear it in post.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, I see what you're gonna do.
Well, first things first, I want Rune back!
One, that's one down.
You don't get your spell! A lot. This is our first run-in with tier 2 spells, though, so you really shouldn't be too surprised.
No revival costs, no weird revival status bullshit this time, from the looks of it.
Yeah.
Or does magic not do that?
Death by any means, or death by direct damage of any kind, does that. Okay, so... Dance is going off, so let's refresh it. with a duster strike. Ooh, crit for 60! Now for some trolling!
Worm your way out of that, yep.
God!
It also suffers from the whole...
Yeah.
And oh hey, that fight actually gives you XP.
Yeah, anything that the game considers a boss, like that fight, gives experience. Hmm. Everything else gives class points instead. So. Saving after that. Wait a minute. Control walk, go! Take me to the healing spring. And yay, control walk back to the save point. Yay, debug powers. God!
No. No. Run.
God damn it! Debug powers didn't save me there!
It's like, fuck this shit, I'm out.
Oh. Okay. Oh, yeah.
So, would this be a good time to...
Probably, yeah. So, thank you all so much for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. I'd be nowhere if you didn't. Above all, I hope you enjoyed this insanity. I will see you in the next video. Goodbye.